Hello, it's the Ghost. Welcome to A Stranger World Than Fiction, where we are taking a look at what's all going on out there. The oddities, the strange, that others are claiming to be true. And today we're dealing with something that, honestly, we can't really pinpoint 100% if any of it is true or not. I'm talking about aliens, one of your favorite topics, and I'm talking about why we don't know everything that everyone else knows. If someone discovered something, why don't we all know about it? Do we feel that things are hidden from us? And what could be a good reason for that? Check this out and let me know your thoughts. Okay, this was posted in August 2021, shared for everyone to see by a non-alien. Dr. Stephen Greer says, aliens consider us a problem civilization. There is overwhelming evidence of alien visits to Earth, says Dr. Stephen Greer. The ufologist claims that representatives of extraterrestrial civilizations have been conducting so-called reconnaissance missions for a long time. At the same time, according to him, aliens are wary of the development of mankind, in particular, regarding the development of weapons of mass destruction. At the same time, Greer added that he has been working on the disclosure of classified information regarding UFOs for 25 years. In an interview, he was asked, Dr. Greer, according to you, we are not alone in the universe, and there have already been many contacts between us and the aliens. But to most, such statements will seem strange. How can we prove once and for all that aliens exist and have already been discovered? Well, the doctor says, that's a very good question. In general, this has already been done. In 2017, the documentary The Unrecognized was released. Have any of you guys seen that documentary? It is named so for the first word in the wording of unrecognized projects with limited access, as the military designates top secret programs related to UFOs and extraterrestrial life. You will see that over 950 military personnel with access to top secret materials have given testimony, documents, and photographs. We even conducted research on a biological sample of extraterrestrial origin. There is irrefutable evidence of alien visits. And frankly, says the doctor, every participant in classified projects knows about it. The public is not told, wanting to keep everything secret for the sake of technology. This secrecy is not related to the so-called aliens, but to geopolitical influence. And what else, guys? You know it. Money, as usual. Next to the doctor is, I have a few questions about your version of the worldview. First of all, are the aliens just coming to us for a while, or have they already firmly settled here? The doctor responds, saying, no, these are recon missions. Since we started testing atomic weapons, the number of visits by extraterrestrial civilizations to our planet has definitely increased. They're clearly concerned about our ability to destroy and our weapons of mass destruction. In the modern period of observations of these so-called UFOs, their number has increased markedly after we developed nuclear weapons and the hydrogen bomb. This is a fact, and we have many witnesses who were involved in top-secret projects and were present at nuclear facilities where alien ships flew in to observe our activities. Many people, in particular, of course, we know them, the science fiction writers. They have helped inspire us with the idea of the risk of some kind of alien invasion or threat. But everyone is quite the opposite, continues the doctor. We are considered a threat. We are. Now human civilization is perceived as unstable, unable to establish peace on the planet. This should have happened after the Second World War, but there is still no change for the better. I think that extraterrestrial intelligence is waiting for our civilization to mature, and until then, it will not take open actions, unless some kind of catastrophe happens. All right, next up for the doctor is, if some civilization has mastered interstellar flights, then we can be considered just a backward hole? Yes, says the doctor, but the problem is this, we are flying into space, aren't we? We have the ISS. We have sent unmanned vehicles to Mars, and in the future, we will launch manned vehicles. We've landed on the moon. By the way, the doctor says my uncle helped design the lunar module in which Neil Armstrong landed. What I'm trying to convey, he says, to the people is this. When we begin to explore space and develop weapons of mass destruction, it became a signal that our civilization is at a certain stage of development and may present a problem. I think we are considered an evolving, but at the same time, problematic civilization. So the main task of all mankind, per the doctor, is to step out of the ape-like fragmented society in which we foolishly fight each other to the stage of peaceful coexistence, when we will fly into space with good goals. When we reach this important milestone, other civilizations will come in contact with humans much more openly. Great theory. What do you guys think? Next up for the doctor is, according to you, there is a special organization that keeps everything related to UFOs a secret. But the aliens would not be limited only to America, and then the authorities of the other world powers would know about them. Is it that there is some kind of international agreement? Well, the doctor says yes. Followed up to the doctor is, or do the authorities of each country themselves determine the course in the field of alien contacts? Doctor says this is a transnational organization. It's worth explaining the difference with an international structure such as the UN. There are no geopolitical boundaries for a transnational organization. For example, there is documented evidence that at the height of the Cold War, the KGB cooperated in this area with American intelligence services. So this issue has been kept secret for decades by the joint efforts of a number of countries. But the lion's share of the work is done by the United States simply by virtue of their technological development and, must be admitted, the enormous macroeconomic influence. To the doctor, based on your book, a documentary called Sirius begins by stating that the financial system for the unjust that brings benefit only to a handful of people and leaves the American middle class with nothing standing power oil corporations. Perhaps all UFO talk is your way, to the doctor, expressing extreme dissatisfaction with what's happening in the real world. Now, this is a very good theory he's proposing here. But the doctor says, no, I just admit the fact that our world is a pale shadow of what it could be if we used technologies developed over the past half century in the framework of various classified projects. We use airplanes and cars, oil and gas, even though we don't really need them. We could have done without them for the past few decades, but it was concluded that the disclosure of new technologies would have a devastating effect on the current macroeconomic system. This discussion, says the doctor, should be conducted by all, together. People are increasingly concerned about issues such as climate change, air pollution, and related deaths. And we've heard about this lately, right, guys? Such problems can be solved, said the doctor, but not with the help of solar or wind energy. It is necessary to use for the benefit of humanity bold scientific discoveries that have been studied for more than a decade in the framework of top secret projects. To the doctor, you also said that not all such discoveries are told to U.S. presidents. They even prepared a special briefing for one president and also spoke before Congress. The interviewer asks, how did everything go? The doctor tells him, I found that everyone wants to know the truth, and that is precisely why I am here now in Washington. This is the biggest secret in history. Even when I first prepared a briefing for the president and director of the CIA, everyone was well aware of the existence of great secrets in the area of aliens. In America, elected officials generally have no control over such projects. If you don't believe me, said the doctor, remember the words from Jimmy Carter, 39th president, after he became president and tried to figure this out. When asked what it was like to be the most powerful person in the world, he replied that it was not about him because he was told about certain things and he had no control over them. For too long, however, though, we have indulged in interests that have become very undemocratic and threatening for world freedom and even our very existence within the biosphere. I've already said that for the United States, this level of secrecy has been a problem since the days of Eisenhower, but it exists in other countries as well, the doctor reiterates. Next up, he is asked, if the question of UFOs is kept so secret that even the presidents don't know, why are you still alive? Why are you allowed to make documentaries for Netflix? The doctor steps up in his own defense, saying three people from his team were killed, including the former director of the CIA. But I would not want to go into details, he says. Nevertheless, we have measures to protect what we are working on. I've collected a lot of data, and if anything happens to me, it will be published on the internet, which will turn out to be a disaster for our opponents. We have been using this mechanism for about 20 years. In addition, I've met people working in the Pentagon and the CIA who, I think, would be happy to publish this information. There's no clear distinction between we and they. Many people from all over the world would love to make this information public. A good friend of mine, says the doctor, Carol Rosen, has worked closely with high-ranking officials in Russia who want the same because they share our views. There are people like that in China, Great Britain, Canada, and probably a lot of other places. So there's definitely progress, but nothing will happen until people understand the gravity of the situation and see the potential for solving all of the problems around the world. The doctor wraps this all up by making a statement, saying, there's a huge amount of evidence, including irrefutable material. We have them, and I've been collecting them for decades. The only question is, who will tell you about it? In the United States, the situation is like this. If some program begins to study in detail the evidence of the existence of UFOs, it will simply be closed. And everyone thinks that the media is free in America, but according to this author, he's saying no. The media is under control. For instance, if CNN started digging deep, it would be told to stop. The author says they have seen this before. We partnered with ABC News, they say, and I gave them 35 hours of highly classified and irrefutable evidence. However, the channel's executive producer was banned from releasing such material. So this was a share that I wanted to share with you guys because it goes along with everything we're doing. I mean, they are keeping things from the people. Sometimes there's good reason for that. Sometimes you have to wonder, why are they doing it? And your answer a lot of the time is because they must be up to no good. What could that be? This is not a conspiracy theory channel, nor is this story a conspiracy theory story. This share is a real interview between two people. Oftentimes, speculation can be confused with conspiracy theory. We can be speculative and have our doubts about what's going on behind the scenes without going full-on conspiracy theory, because we're not into that here. We're trying to get the truth. What do you guys think is the real reason that we do not have full disclosure here from what the scientists find with regards to other beings in other places to us? Why can't we know? What do you think it is? Will we be terrified and panic? Because that's a very good one. If they give up their hiding places if they're here, we probably all would want to go visit it. That could be another good reason why we just can't be controlled and therefore we cannot know everything. Sometimes there are good reasons why we can't know it all. But sometimes there just doesn't seem to be a reason at all and nothing makes any sense. So I'm curious how you guys feel about that. Not knowing, does that make you angry or protected? Share your thoughts, and thank you for listening, and I will talk to you all soon.